LegalMatch has been probably one of the single most crucial factors to my ability to be able to practice in my own firm. And that's been, I mean, it's been essential. I had offers and I had folks come to me from other firms. This is when I left my practice at an insurance defense firm, who were willing to bring me on into their firm. And, you know, and I told them, well, you know, I have a client referral service right now and that I've been pretty satisfied with. And they said, well, if you've got a service, we'd be happy to compensate for you. And frankly, I haven't been in a place where I've really desired to give that up. I appreciate the freedom and the flexibility that LegalMatch provides, and they have provided me a steady stream of potential clients. And the clients that I have had have all turned out to be very good clients. And you know, I'm able to, you know, schedule as I need to schedule. I get clients usually comes in waves, about two, sometimes three times a month, where I'll get, you know, three or four each, you know, during each point in time. And that is, you know, that's sufficient to keep the office going. So that's what I really, I've appreciated about LegalMatch, and it's been a very important, absolutely crucial aspect to my being able to practice in my own firm. Well, you know, about 80% of my business has come from LegalMatch at this point in time. And it provides a consistent stream of clients, potential clients and clients that who have anywhere from very small matters of simply a few thousand dollars to matters that are dealing with resources in the millions. So, you know, my work can range from, you know, a simple contract review all the way to a protracted litigation endeavor that might take years. And so, you know, for me, it's been a extremely important to be able to have that consistency through a service company or referral company, and LegalMatch has definitely provided that. I think that the ability for me to be able to draw in customers and clients from a mobile standpoint, from a remote standpoint, has been crucial here. There's a lot of people that don't feel comfortable meeting in person, and for me, for my first contact with these potential customers and clients to be through either via email or telephone, I think it's allowed me to continue to practice where I want to practice, which is, you know, I have an office here at the house, and although I am in partnership with my brother down in Eugene, you know, it provides a tremendous amount of flexibility for me and my family to be able to be at the house and sometimes even welcome clients into the house to have a meeting or have a discussion. And for me, it's extremely important, especially to be there for my children when they're young. I've got four kids that are all under 7 years old. So, you know, we're a very busy household, and it often requires me going out and dropping them off at school or piano or violin or baseball, dance, a variety of activities. So for me, it's about the flexibility, and it's really provided me that ability during the pandemic. I like that it's largely self-managed. I don't feel that I'm being, you know, oversold or undersold a product. It's fairly automatic from the standpoint that I don't have to worry about sending out marketing blasts and emails and whatnot. But for the most part, you know, I receive leads, and I'm able to call the leads when I have a moment in my day to do so. And I try to get to the potential clients, you know, as quickly as possible. I send out an email usually first to them, and then I will follow up with a phone call. And, you know, for me, that has been, you know, a tremendous resource in being able to, you know, I guess, handle the face-to-face with the client and not have to worry about reaching out initially or sending a marketing blast, those types of things. So I think that's the real value that LegalMatch provides is, you know, I kind of know when LegalMatch is doing some promotions, because that's usually when I receive about three or four leads, about three times a month. And then I can contact them. I usually contact them shortly after. And it's always provides for a really interesting array of cases and issues as well. But that's an aside. Yeah, as I mentioned, I get leads about three times a month. And as I said, it comes in waves. So the waves come in about three times a month, of about anywhere from three or four leads. So, you know, I get about overall maybe 9 to 12 leads a month. And that's plenty. And I'm actually, you know, I'm looking at ways of being able to take on more of those clients, and so that I don't have, because many of the cases I simply can't take just because of my bandwidth. But I am looking at opportunities to be able to take more and more clients as they come in. I would say anywhere from 30 to 40%, and I think that that's pretty realistic. There's several cases that, you know, that'll come through that, you know, I will decide for one reason or another I may not want. But what I always try to do is I always try to provide a consultation to that individual, because their cases might be more suited to for themselves handling in a small claims transaction or something, or perhaps there's a unique specialization that perhaps I just cannot fill at that particular moment. But if there is something along those lines where the client has a special need, I will usually try to take the time, the 15 minutes that I have, to be able to guide them to what they need at that particular moment. So if it's an understanding of the small claims process, I will describe the small claims process. I will show them how to get to the small claims documents through the court's website. And, or I will, if it's a specialization that they need, I will explain to them, this is the type of issue you're dealing with. This is the terminology you're dealing with. And this is who you need to be looking for to be able to help you with the matter. So there's a variety of ways that I help. I mean, if you ask me the question, how many clients do I help that come through LegalMatch? I would say I'm usually able to help 90 to 100% of the clients in some small way. And if it's something where I'm actually engaging them for a fee, I would say somewhere around 30 to 40%. I haven't been involved with other lead generated systems. I've heard from other attorneys using other systems that are, you know, I think every lead generator is different. I understand that one of my colleagues with whom I work down in Los Angeles has a lead generated system, and that lead generated system is particularly targeted at a type of demographic, whereas I think LegalMatch doesn't necessarily target a type of demographic. They have a little bit more broad reach than, which is good for me. I'm fine with that. I do like a variety of client matters. That's one of the aspects of my practice that I enjoy the most, is how diverse and varied my day-to-day is and my caseload is. So for me, that's extremely important. I think that it's probably not unique, but I think that it's an element that is that I've found to be very beneficial to myself and the way that I practice. I get the most out of my LegalMatch membership by contacting all of the leads that come through. And I find that if I do that and I take the time and I don't try to prejudge any kind of post, I often find that there are really good cases sometimes found in the most oblique posts. And so it's important not to read too much into what the potential client or the client is actually posting initially. It's important to pick up the phone, talk to them, find out what their actual issues are, ask very specific pointed questions, and make a deduction from there whether it would be a good case or not for the firm to handle. The tip that I would have is to make sure that you call each and every client, that or potential client, that you discuss with them, offer some kind of a, you know, consultation window. In my case, it's 15 minutes. I try not to go too much over that because that it can be a burden on the resource of time. But with about a 15-minute consultation, I found that I can usually dissect a matter and get to the heart of it and be able to provide some idea for the potential client or the client as to how they should be proceeding. And I can usually get in a few minutes of about myself or and what I would charge and my fees if I were to offer them my services. I would try also to, you know, be more generous on my estimates with cases that I'm not as familiar with, or at least material or areas of practice that I'm not as familiar with, and to not expect that, you know, that we should be receiving top dollar for everything that we do. We need to be flexible. We need to adapt. And in order to practice, particularly to practice on your own, you have to continue to grow and challenge yourself. And that comes with entering into new territories. I would tell an attorney thinking about getting a LegalMatch membership that the lead generation is really fantastic. I've gotten a consistent, steady stream of clients and potential clients through LegalMatch. Their support is very good. Anytime I've wanted to reach somebody through LegalMatch, I've been able to do that. And that's a very important thing, as well as customer service. Their customer service is really terrific. And I wouldn't be saying these things if I didn't have such a great experience myself with LegalMatch. I've gotten very, very good cases from LegalMatch. I've gotten an incredible amount of satisfaction in the practice and the work that I do because of LegalMatch. And I would say that it is definitely worth the resources and the investment to get a LegalMatch subscription or to partner with LegalMatch in order to provide leads, because it more than pays for itself. And in that sense, it's a sustainer for the business. Well, I would say that making that personal connection is the best marketing advice I could give. Making the personal connection with the leads, calling them, discussing with them, talking a little bit about their issue with them, and also finding out a little bit more about their personal lives. I think people really appreciate speaking to a human being. And when it comes down to the practice of law, it can feel a little bit cold at times. And I know that from the feedback I've received from my clients is that they have thanked me at the end of their matter for being real, being human, and the fact that, you know, I have a family and kids, and I share things with them about what's happening in my own life, and I like to hear about what's happening in their lives.